Are we good?
Yeah, we're good.
I'm recording, by the way. All right. Hello, I got Madeline Doherty here. I don't know. Let's just have a chat because fucking shit's been weird, isn't it?
Very weird. Very weird. I thought we may as well just jump on, hey?
We'll just see what happens. If it's shit, I just won't post it. But like, if anyone that's listening, the reason I wanted to talk to you is like we just had the most epic chat on the phone the other day. I'm like, fuck. I'm like, yeah, because you can't tell when it's going to come up, and then you plan to do a recording. It's not the same, right? It's just not. It's not as organic, especially when it's like you're trying to do an interview format. I fucking hate that. But like, I don't know. Like, yeah, what were we even talking about the other day? It was wild.
We're talking about water. We know water is going to be a theme in this next conference. I mean, we're kicking off with Will Keller doing the water
All right, so
presentation.
yeah, actually, that's why we're doing the video. So
Yeah, and then it's flowing on from the last conference because we had so many things drop with that one. And I reckon you need to reiterate your awareness and understanding about what you came to in that video. When everyone got up you for your hat, which I don't know why they were focusing on that at the time, but when you were speaking about martial law and the whale, oh, you've got Rip Curl now, so hopefully no one's upset about that.
Yeah.
You know that.
I know what you mean. Like that when that whale thing came in about a year ago, it comes in, it goes, comes in, it goes, and every time it comes in, I understand another layer of it. So, and definitely 100%. I'm gonna start speaking more fucking affirmative about things because sometimes you're like, oh, it could be this. I'm like, no, it is this on one layer. That doesn't mean it's, I don't get the other layers, but like 100%, the story of the whale is the story. The hijack of that story is maritime admiralty law,
Yeah.
and the manifestation. Well, they call it a certificate of manifest, the birth certificate. And this is mimicking to me. It's mimicking the story of creation from the water into physical reality. So to me, the way, you hear the whale story, the whale comes to land.
Yeah.
It's stupid mythology, right? Now there could be a literal interpretation of that, and I'm sure there is, but the interpretation I've got is that is the dissension, our dissension into separation onto physical reality or 3D,
Yeah, and well,
and that the whale represents the intuition and the way home. It's a reminder of who we
yes.
are. It's a reminder of who we are. It kind of doesn't belong in this realm. We kind of look at it in like fascination, and it's because that being is it's like I've said before in the movie Inception, he's got a little spinny ball. He's in a fake reality, and he doesn't know. The only thing that reminds him that he remembers to go back home is there's something that's out of place within the construct, and what's out of place here is the whale, and it's connecting to our intuition, and that everything that's coming up for me now too is the entire control system of this reality is all through the brain, and it's not just through the brain. It's through an energetic overlay of the body, but it mostly through the brain, and that the heart is the way out, and it's that simple.
And it's interesting as well, because I was even thinking the other day when we were speaking about water, like obviously the age of Aquarius is an air sign, but it's the water bearer. And
Yeah.
so it's kind of like as this land grab and this can kind of continual, like this looping starts to take place again. It's like there is this way home, but they're hijacking that expression and that change. Through the takeover, which is like that, it's cycling through again, where it is this, law of the water coming onto the land, you know what I mean? And so we're seeing that, and I think that's why as well, on one level, why the whale's coming up for so many people as well, because it really it's I mean it's I mean there's so, like you say, there's so many levels to it, because
Yeah, there's many
even
that
when
we
you look
don't get yet. There's a lot we don't get yet
exactly.
that we're going to. I know we're going to.
Yeah, I know. We are definitely. It's just been phenomenal. But yeah, I mean, yeah, because I shared that thing as well when I was, when I was in the in the, I call it the grid, in the grid a month ago or so, and I just wanted a bit of a break from the artificial frequencies. And I was like, oh, I'm going to put up like a lead shield around me to block, you know, in the unseen, to block the frequencies coming in. And my spirit was like, no, lead won't work. It'll also block the organic. And I'm like, okay, what will work? It showed me this dome that was like, it was like a water web. Like a water web. That's the only way I can kind of put it. And it's like you program the water web to only allow the organic frequencies to come in and not the artificial frequencies to come in. And so I put that around me, and then, and I felt incredible the entire time I was there. And then I sort of had this thing drop. Oh, it's the fascia. And then I've been. Yeah,
fucking talk about this. This is what you were talking about the other day.
Yeah, well, it was so interesting because the fascia, my sister's done a lot of research around the fascia, and I wanted to actually do a call with her to speak about it, because when I was out on country, like about a month ago or so, like I was just going for a walk, and, you know, as I do, I was sort of like communicating with the trees and the birds and all the things. And I was sort of like with this tree, and I was like, what can I do for you? Like, what do you need? You know, because it's kind of like, it's near my home, the home I'm living at the moment. And it was like, your presence is enough. And I remembered thinking, oh my gosh, there's a little echidna walking along my driveway. That's so funny. Okay. And I was like, that's so interesting, because in when it comes to fascia, so all these keys are dropping, right? When it comes to fascia, from what I've heard from my sister and a few people, it's kind of like the awareness of different spaces actually brings healing to the body. So it's like you bring, say your shoulder's sore, you bring awareness to your shoulder, and you actually allow, I guess your, you know, homeopaths might call it the vital force. So your innate intelligence goes to that area to create healing and balance back into the system. And really it has a lot to do with like the awareness on your body, right? And so a lot of the time when we don't have awareness of things, we tend to hold and clamp, and it creates discord and imbalance. And I was thinking about that, applying it to the earth. And, you know, what came up a lot was Sky to Earth was like, the earth gets lonely and the earth actually needs us to walk upon her. And I was thinking, well,
yeah, that was like my biggest takeaway.
Yeah, like, so our awareness and connection on the earth is actually what heals her.
Yeah.
Just like the body. When we have awareness and connection to our body, you know, and essentially like it's like that's different to your head. So when you're in your head all the time, when you're just in your thoughts, and this is just like a physical thing for people, when you're just in your thoughts, you're disconnected from your body, right? And that can create imbalance. So the same as when we're on our tech all the time, or we're like in our, you know, we're focusing on these other stuff all the time and not out on the earth, you know, disconnecting us. I mean, there's so many layers to this when I'm speaking, right? And I know you get that. But it's like when we're out on the earth and we actually have that awareness of the earth, meaning we acknowledge the spirit of the earth, right? Just like when you're, you know, acknowledging your body that it has intelligence, right? And that is what creates healing. That's what creates balance. And I reckon there's a massive key when it comes to fascia. And because we can learn so much about the earth through our biology.
Can you explain what fascia is too? Aren't there like, they're like these filtration systems in the body because like Josh was talking about this with fluid dynamics, wasn't he, on the call?
Yeah. Yeah. Look, I'm not an expert. This is why I think it's going to be great.
I don't know shit about it, but yeah.
Yeah. When we can ask, it's just come up recently for me.
Explain this, Mads. Talk about what the fascia is, and then tie it into hydrogel and what they've done with hydrogel.
Oh yeah.
What's the black goo shit, right? What do they call it?
Yeah, well that I
because
think
that's a mimic. What, that's a mimicking.
That's the web. They're creating that artificial web within the body with the hydrogel.
Yeah, because it's mimicking the natural what would happen with fascia, right?
Yeah, and I think as well, because water, we know water can be programmed and hold information. I'm wondering around, because I was sort of shown, well, Spirit sort of said like the fascia can be programmed. Like when I'm using the fascia to protect me from EMFs, it's like the fascia can be programmed to accept or filter in certain things. And I'm wondering, I'm assuming the fascia does hold program. I'm assuming the fat, and then there's other levels to that. Do you know what I mean? Because the fascia is a physical manifestation of the web within us, right? And outside of us. So there's so many levels to it. I don't know it very well, Dale. Like I've been watching, listening to podcasts and stuff about it, but I guess because I'm sort of in putting the awareness and interpreting it in how you look, seeing it in nature, it's going to be really great to get even Tom Barnett, because I know he knows so much about the physical body. Barnett and
Josh. This is why I love the last conference, right? Because we kind of don't even know where these themes are going, right? Like you knew a few people, I knew a few people, and they just the way they fucking molded together and the conversations become like a larger conversation that each individual guest wouldn't have even known about, right? It's so bizarre how it worked out like that. And I can already see with the new one that the guests that we got coming on, there's a different story playing out, right? And I think this one, it's like another layer, it's going deeper, this one. I really want what's real now. Like stop with the bullshit. Like we fucking want truth, right? And we're gonna cut to the core of like a lot of this bullshit. And I won't even talk about it now, but like fucking they're like the Christian revival movement is fucking terrifying, right? It is a program of the construct. Hey, I mean, I could go on forever about this. I wouldn't mind doing a full presentation if you give me one session. but I know we're going to go into it with one of the guests anyway, aren't we? So it's going to be. Sorry, I'll say this to people: like, if anyone wants to join the conference, like, do not fucking come on if you're not willing to have your dogma challenged. Not to say that we know what is true, but like, if you're not willing to strip away belief systems, and I don't believe everything that every guest tells us, not at all. I actually fundamentally disagreed with some of the points that some of the last guests we put on. That's the fucking imbalance of what we see in the public to why we're doing a closed course. That is the purpose of it, because we don't want people coming on that have got these distorted dogmatic fucking viewpoints. It's like if you haven't got a balanced mindset to come in and take information and not be fucking triggered or allow yourself to be challenged by things, then don't come on. So
We've attracted a very high caliber group of people for the last one. Like I've just been blown away by the intelligence and just awareness in that group. Like
the members, the people that joined.
Yeah, because I sort of was like, do these people exist? And, you know, yeah, they do. So,
the last call when we opened up for Q&A, I'm just blown away by the people that are on there, right? They're not like Dale, Madeline, sycophants that fucking, you know, like believe what we say. Like these are all, they're very, very grounded people, the people that we got in there. Right.
I think that's why it's so, you know, it's such a different space, because I mean our intention is balance. That's been kind of clear from the start, and really, you know, seeing all perspectives and seeing, I guess, the law of correspondence through it all. And so there aren't that many spaces like that, because a lot of the time when people have podcasts, for instance, they're kind of bringing in people that's really in their line of thinking or line of awareness to kind of, do you know what I mean? That kind of like they've got a certain theme they're speaking about or thing that they're talking about. So they bring certain people on the space. I'm not saying that's bad, but a space like this, we're literally bringing in such a wide range of people, but then we have this balancing point where we come back and have those group discussions about all the different topics. And a lot of the people that come on have no idea what the other presenters are speaking about. Yeah. So they're just in from their, you know, their own like awareness around stuff. And then we're seeing all these keys drop. I mean, some of the calls, especially near the middle after we've had presentations prior to, it was like, what? Like it was
I'll say for people that if anyone wants to come on, by the end of it, you will understand different, like just by joining in and watching, because this happened to me, right? We were like co-hosts, but fuck man, like did it help us? I like my perspectives on things, and like particularly, you know, like when we have Clint on, you know, like you could just do 10 sessions with Clint and learn something new every time, right? And I just love like just hearing his, you know, his stories and his knowledge of lore and stuff, right? And then you get someone like Will Keller on, right, who's really coming from, you know, like he's brought all that together too, but he's showing how to implement that in the new world, right? And Clint wouldn't know anything about Will Keller but how much they relate, but how much, because you don't see the bigger picture and the layers, because Clint's talking about one layer, Will's talking about another layer. It's the same thing, the exact same thing. It's just, you know, and it's fucking magic, man. Like, anyway, so like, thanks for letting me in.
Oh, well, it wouldn't be without
you. Hey, I'll tell you the other thing, like, because we were like trying to talk on here before, and like, fuck the interference with what we were talking about, we probably won't bring up, but isn't it smooth now? What's going on? It's like,
yeah, I don't know. Maybe we're not dropping too many truth bombs. Maybe.
But I'll say this one thing too, then I'll let you talk. So, from what I've observed, anything we talk about, whatever controls this and what we're in, what is trying to control us, kind of doesn't really give a shit about anything you talk about, right? You can talk about fucking ritual abuse. You can talk about, all sorts of things. It doesn't care. But the moment you start trying to get to the core of artificial intelligence and what that is and what and how deep that goes and how many layers that goes, everything fucks up tech-wise. Everything. So we probably won't even talk about it for yet.
And even when I speak about reconnecting with the earth, and I don't just mean going for a walk in the park, I mean really getting, you know, and when I speak about that and share examples of like that, like I did last night, like the example I shared you after, had some interference after that, like anytime I do that, it feels like this awareness, whatever it is within us and outside of us, whatever it is, doesn't want us to remember that. And yeah, I mean,
because all that is the polar opposite of the controller is the earth. That's it, fucking hates that. And if you look at Agenda 21 and what they're going to do with the voice, it's all bringing people into the city. And I spoke to someone yesterday up on the Sunshine Coast, and they said they're in real estate, and they're talking about the housing plans now. They said there's not going to be any more sprawl on the Sunshine Coast. It's all going up. It's all being built up. And I've seen in the Bendigo Bendigo Housing Development Plan, 85% of all development within the CBD up. Everything's going up. Because
buildings.
Yeah. And
I thought you meant up the coast.
But they don't, the last thing the controller of this fucking realm wants is you to be on country. It hates that. It cannot allow that. And people need to ask that question. Why does it not want you to be on the land? Because something's happening to the land. Something's happening to the earth.
It's and really I feel it. I
and
feel
it doesn't it. Want you to be a part of it. It does not. It wants you stuck into a fucking synthetic grid in a city.
Mm.
Do not
connect. And I know. Yeah. And I know, you know, because we know that there's many levels to this, right? And I always say the towers and I say the tech and all that because that's the name I give it. But I know this is interdimensional, right?
Oh, yeah.
But I'm telling you, every single time I'm out of the grid, the energy in that space, and it's not just because, what is that? Some green juice drink.
I just found out the other day watching that video that the nicotine is in celery juice. Did you know that?
Really?
Yeah, and it actually has the same binding effect. So if you have chewing tobacco, that this fucking gets rid of all the gunk out of the body because the nicotine receptors, they binds onto the nicotine, and that's why celery juice fucking detoxifies and
gets rid of the gunk.
It's the nicotine.
Need to get some sea celery.
Anyway, sorry, I keep fucking interrupting you. Go.
No, it's fine. This is what we do all through the conference. Everyone can get used to that as well.
Hey, by the way, like when I was going through, actually, I'll put it on the end of this video. I'll put the promo of the last one.
What, the Harry Potter thing?
Oh, they're like, it's just like, I just, yeah, it was fucking funny because I went back and watched everything. I went, holy shit, this conference was really good. Like when I went back and like I didn't realize because it goes over such a long period of time. And then
No, yeah.
I went fuck. And then like I found the one, and I'm like, just this just perfectly encompasses Madeline. I'm trying to talk on a topic, and you just kept fucking interrupting with your absolute lack of knowledge of cinema. And you're like, oh yeah, that's like Harry Potter. I'm like, can you shut the fuck up for one second?
I actually think you need to go back and watch that scene on Harry Potter because I think you will get a lot out of it, to be honest.
I don't know.
But it
I've
was
got
pretty.
some. There's something in you that like, there's something in you that triggers me, and I don't like you being right. It's like something.
Know, because when
I
I
have
said
to like
you
shut you
have to
down a
do
little
it.
bit because I don't know, like your ego sometimes. I'm just gonna like
I
smash
think it's, yeah, I think. No, I think everyone's like that, but I really think everyone's like that towards me because I can be quite like, this is the truth. Which, I humble myself and humble my ass all the time, but I
That's what I
like
was gonna say. I want to finally meet your husband Ash just to just to get some questions out of him.
I know. I was like wondering, like, what would he say? So funny.
Anyway, what are we talking about?
Oh, you've taken me off track. What were you talking
Sorry,
about?
no, you're talking about tech, right? And the tech's
Oh
interdependent.
yeah, when I'm out of the grid, the feeling is like nothing else. Like there is actually something else going on outside of it. And I know, like when I say, because knowing that there's multiple levels, so the these light frequencies, because that's what they are. We're in a universe of light. I think that's what people forget. We've got an invisible light spectrum. We've got the visible light spectrum, we've got the invisible light spectrum, and these frequencies are creating invisible light artificially. So on, there's one level that they're an artificial frequency that is transferring information one point to the other, but there's another level to that, right? And so the way I see it, when I'm out of the grid, it's not just that I'm out of the grid, it's like I don't know how to explain it, but it's if we know that these frequent artificial frequency bandwidths are in a certain area and they're not in other areas, we know that there's other things happening on that level. And I would love to get my friend Hux on to the conference. She's not big on talking publicly, but she always talks about she calls it the underworld frequencies. She's like these, the grids is like literally creating like a habitat for underworld beings because it's not only these lower octave light frequencies, but they are also, they are also artificial, so
Well,
it's not connected with the earth, it's not
that's what
organic.
they say with the Archons. The Archons are here to make this realm theirs. They're trying to sync it with their realm. But this is why I always think everything, right? So if the if there's a synthetic grid over the earth, we can tune into both the organic and synthetic grid, and the cities resemble much more of the synthetic, right? And if we're a compression of the earth.
You've got to know what the organic feels like, though.
Yes,
Like
that's
a
it.
lot of people have actually forgotten who they are. They've forgotten what it feels like to be connected to the earth. They've actually forgotten what that
Yeah, it's
is in their
amnesia.
body. They've forgotten
Amnesia.
what it feels like in their heart, And so it's like the normalization of this artificial way of
But
being.
so there's a point I'm getting to, right? If the Earth has a synthetic overlay over it, which I believe it does, and we're a compression of the Earth, then we must have a synthetic frequency or overlay over our own body, right? And
Trips me out when you share that.
the and then this it, to me, this is why everything is trying to rule us by emotion. What we're seeing now in Palestine and Israel, it's emotion. Your emotion goes out into a synthetic overlay of your body, and it feeds that. It feeds that into that fucking central figure. And it's oh well that's what yeah we, oh I'll fucking talk about Palestine, Israel. We'll leave that alone. But I'm seeing that as a microcosm of separation on Earth. It's coming to a unity point of it, like a final conflict, because it's a microcosm of separation. And that what the synthetic grid is trying to do is trying to mimic the what's happening in the organic, because we're coming into a point of unity. So it's going to have a final showdown of separation between these two sides. And what the synthetic is trying to do is perform a ritual to bring people back to the false god in the ritual that they're going to perform out. And the reason that the synthetic must mimic the organic, so that tells you that the organic is actually coming into unity as well. And so they're just trying to perform, they're trying to perform a global ritual that they're going to bring us a false sense of unity under a not real love, not real unity, but a mimicked love and a mimicked unity. And all this is for us is to differentiate the difference between true love and the false love, or real light and the false light. And that none of that can be done through the head, and it can't be taught either. It doesn't matter how much you read, you can't learn that. And you can probably only learn that.
That is so true. I mean, I feel like it's even interesting, because it's like you can differentiate it within your heart, but then you also have to understand that the heart, like you say, has an overlay, and we have a certain feeling of a connection with our own heart and our own emotions, and which emotions are artificially activated and which ones are actually.
Well, like love and bliss and euphoria are different things, right? So a lot of people that may get in contact with certain beings, all right, or that are saved, they will describe a period of bliss or euphoria, right? It's euphoria by the being. Mm. Like true love is a balance state. And it's not, and it's a balance between you and the other being that you're interacting with. If a being is soliciting worship or you're bowing to it, or it's showering you with love, that's an imbalance. There's not a balance and connection of the two.
And you
learn
that by being out in nature.
How so?
You learn that by being out in nature.
Yeah, well,
observe, but also, yeah.
Yeah, well, you can explain that more, because. Yeah, I wouldn't say it's like bliss or euphoria in nature, is it? It's like it's like that peace.
No, it's but then even the word peace has been hijacked by religion, because I don't think people really understand what peace feels like. Because peace is balance. Peace is not bliss and total, like being totally, you know, in a state of, you know.
Well, do you know, like if you take MDMA, right, you have like extreme euphoria. That's what that drug does, right? So it gives you like, you know, unbelievable levels of like bliss and euphoria. And then what happens is it crashes down, because it's a light-based universe of duality. So if you go in the extreme of the imbalance of taking MDMA, you're going to come down to the depression side when you come down as well. And it's the exact same when you're talking about interdimensional beings or other or gods, right? That they're presenting you with euphoric love and bliss. That's a distorted energy. That it's not a balanced energy. That being is not of the true love, because it's presenting a euphoric. You can see that. It's just like taking a drug. It's interdimensional spiritual drug taking. And people quit alcohol for 20 years. They're like, oh, I was an alcoholic, I'm a drug addict, and now I'm a new ager and I meditate. It's like you're doing the same thing. You're just spiritual drug taking, right? You're not in a balanced state. You have to get off on you know, fucking bringing the energy up your body and through the pineal and all that junk, right? You're not in a balanced state.
Yeah, that's right. And what about, like, did Clint share this in the recent Sky to Earth about how there's no word for love? It's actually respect is the highest, you know, the highest kind of connection or compliment or, you know, whatever you want to call it.
But there's no word and for so hate either. There's no word for hate.
It's like, that's right, yeah. But it's like the respect of the earth, right? You know, and the respect that you receive back, and the respect that you have for people, and the respect, you know, there's a different respect is different, you know, it's so like, cause when I use the word love, really in my heart, I'm thinking respect. I think like that really just holds so much. And if you're thinking about an interdimensional being or a being that's wanting worship, essentially they're not respecting you for the being that you are, right? They are interfering with you. They're not respecting your rights as a sovereign spirit, you know, going through an evolutionary journey. They're actually interfering with you, which means they're not respecting you, which means they don't really love you. You know, so it's like
it falls on the belief of hierarchy too, because people just think hierarchy on Earth, and everything is as above, so below. So if we have these hierarchical structures on the planet, that is a fractal. There is spiritual hierarchy, right? These spiritual entities and gods have fucking egos. They've got egos, right?
Yeah. Exactly.
Anyway, so and let's again, like let's shatter every paradigm in this.
I also come in to shatter my own as well.
Anyway, I'm probably I'm feeling this winding up. I've got stuff to do. So do you want
jumped on and did it.
Yeah, well, yeah. Do you want should we announce anyone that's coming on? Or do you I'm gonna do another promo video next week. So mate, should I wait till then
we'll leave it. You can share the link. People can jump on and share.
Yeah.
Have a look.
I'll put out a promo video next week because we've got to finalize a couple more speakers, don't we? But like it's gonna be awesome. And I'll link that. I'll put that video at the end of this. Of just the last conference, if people want to have a look.
Promise the whole thing to be interrupting Dale, but some of
I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be good.
Yeah, good time. Awesome. All right. Thanks for the yarn.
No worries, mate. Anything else you want to say?
Bring it on.
Bring it on, motherfuckers. Yeah, I've got plenty more to share, but we'll leave it for now. And I'm gonna hang up, and you'll go, because I'm doing this new thing where to make sure that it downloads, because I've had all these problems.
Okay, no worries.
Is that right?
Yes. All right, see ya.
Have a good day. All right, last one.
What?
So conference starts November 16th, and I'll put a link below if anyone wants to join. Hope to see you there if you want to come in.
Join us, two larrikins, bringing in a whole heap of incredible minds.
Oh, see you, mate.
See ya.
Right.
We spoke a root language, and that's what Magyar was. And it's been well established by Attila Flink and by other people as well that this was the root language right around the world, because real truth cannot be told. You know, we live in a society where people believe that making a mistake or being wrong is the most evil, terrible thing you can do, and you'll lose complete faith and lose face in front of all your friends, and everyone will think you're an idiot from now on. And yet it's how we learn. This is what we do. We make mistakes. We come here to make mistakes so we can learn how to do things properly. You can't build a house without hitting your thumb with a hammer a couple of times. I mean, this is the way it works, you know. So you can't tell people the truth. They're scared of it. You've got to encourage them to ask the right questions, because when they ask the right questions, the right answers will present themselves. So real truth needs to be realized. It can never be told.
Now we're back to the Matrix. What is the Matrix, guys? The truth of the matter is, the simple definition of hypocrisy is simulation. Simulation is hypocrisy. Is the Matrix a language? Is it a code? Is it a place? Is it a thing? No. It's right here. There's only one place that hypocrisy or simulation can come from, and that's you. So don't take it literally. Take it as a metaphor, as it's supposed to be, that you're participating in legalized adultery, or in other words, simulation.
Spiders, the golden orb weaver spider in particular, is a really good spirit. And it was this spirit is connected to women and to the seven sisters. And it was this spider being that taught women how to weave, and it also taught them how to navigate the heavens, because all the stars in the sky are all interlinked by the spider's web.
So interesting.
But I just recently found out that all the stars, like the galaxies and all these different things, you know, they talk about what's that thing called? Gravity is an invisible force that sort of links things together. But there's another thing called dark matter. And dark matter is apparently what keeps all of the galaxies connected to each other, like an invisible web. And that's what science is saying now.
So are you saying that the spider's weaving the dark matter?
The dark matter.
Well, it's an invisible web that joins all the stars together.
And then the ones that lead all to the alternative is the just them doing the opposite, so that they run their same programs through the New Age movement and all that sort of stuff, which then leads people probably even further off path than the mainstream. I used to always say that I would prefer a normie wife than a quote unquote a woken wife, because she would be a nightmare to deal with, and a normie would be better, because she'd just be like, yeah, you can work and I'll make you some dinner and let's just go and enjoy our time on the weekend, not trying to ride unicorns to the fifth dimension and then everything I say is like wrong and shit and I've got to listen to her for 5 hours while she meditates and then talks to me, and then it's like, no, I don't want to do that. So
Dale and I have spoken about this so much.
Yeah, I've been nailed it, man.
For about a month, the same thing kept coming up, that karmic ties and soul contracts were dissolving, which really messed me up, because that's a lot of what I work with clients, so particularly, you know, if they're interested in a relationship with somebody. You know, I can pick up whether or not they've got some sort of soul connection, past life connection, those sorts of things. But these things are all being dissolved right now. So when I looked deeper into it, because I wanted my guys to explain this to me, they explained that we've just come to the end of this 25,000 year incarnation cycle, and that we're not stuck in that cycle anymore. We've come into a time of free will, pure free will. So the people that we're with, the jobs that we have, the family members that we're in contact with, that is all free will now. It's not karmically tied. We're not tied to anything. We are completely free, and we're free until the end of this lifetime. The first shot of one of the portals. So if you allow your eyes to go relaxed and look at this photo, you might notice there's actually an anomaly in this part of the photograph. Now, for it to be just in one photograph, that's fine. But I've taken shots from all around this portal now. I went there yesterday to take more shots, because I didn't have any from back here or to the side, and now I do. I first took photographs and noticed this in 2016 in this particular location. Okay, so I'm just gonna go backwards and forwards a couple of times so people can sort of hopefully notice where that circle is. Now, taking in into consideration again, so this is a Muntree patch. This is a ground cover. It's actually got a lovely little berry that tastes like cinnamon apples in summertime. But what's interesting with these portals and the energy lines is the plants try not to grow in them. You'll get ground covers, but you won't get anything in these nexus points where the different energy lines will feed into a larger portal. It'll just have nothing there. And that's another sign. If you can see, if you're walking along a path and then notice there's this circular pattern in the pathway, and then you're standing in a spot where you can see another circular pattern next to that in another pathway, and where you're standing is completely empty and there's only ground covers, that could be a portal spot.
About why you're talking about astrology, you know, it's a modality, it's an external thing. And I was saying this, what you shared, the same as with me, like I look at the numbers 1 to 9, they're all archetypes, they're frequencies and vibrations of energy manifested to a particular archetype, and you can feel it just like a color or a sound or whatever, right? And or a planet in an astrology chart. It's like what you're actually studying is the self. yes, okay, it's an external study of a higher wisdom, but what you're actually doing is whatever you're doing is you, something's rippled out there and it's reflecting back to you so that you can know thyself deeper. And then when, and then it keeps moving because then it goes out again. So contraction, expansion. As I know thyself deeper, I now understand all of you and the whole all existence deeper. And it just keeps moving. And it's like the heartbeat, contraction, expansion. That's what a heartbeat is. And that's very much how I sort of feel into why I get numbers working for me the way they do. And I think the modalities choose us. And the reason they choose us is because they want us to evolve that modality.
The external collective responsibilities, is that of your own, or is it, it's purely the individual?
In reality, in truth, there is no such thing as a collective. We say collective, this is a descriptive term, meaning the totality of individuals, right? So yes, it is all about the individual in this reality. So yeah, so when we talk about we need to reach aggregate freedom, that means the majority of individuals need to understand objective morality and align their actions to what is right. Aided goal. The most accurate definition of true freedom is the ability to exercise one's natural rights without the inhibition of violence, duress, and or coercive restraint initiated by others. Simply put, free will, unrestricted free will expression.
Change the fluid dynamics and get them to move. So if you think of that river stream versus swamp's the best way to look at it. The only way to get the swamp clean again is to flush, put new water in and get the old shit out. And that's all the body's ever doing. That's why you got artery delivering new stuff in the vein and lymph taking the old stuff away. And so the tissues only get ill or sick or tight or feeling crap and inflamed if that lymph isn't moving, because it's all the gunk just pooling there. So it's like your toilet just not going anywhere, not going to a sewage farm, it just goes down into the floor. The floors wouldn't want to be, you know. So same with the tissues. If the old shit doesn't move out, it'll continually toxify the tissues. It needs to be removed and the new stuff brought in to reoxygenate. So on. So a lot of our techniques are based on that kind of thing.
It was almost like in spirit it would prey on people that were sick or didn't have control over like themselves and their autonomy, and because he was a doctor, give your like autonomy over to me and I will heal you. And that was the energy that I felt from it, like he wanted to play doctor. So I get all this pretty stuff that's about to come.
The utopia.
Yeah, there's a lot of pretty stuff coming.
Yeah, but that's what I've said, mate, because it's the sales pitch is the utopia and it's the candy. It looks beautiful. But it, like you said, because people are like, oh, how will we know? It's like, if you can read that energy, the subtlety in what's being presented, and if it's fake, like you'll pick it up straight away.
It's like when you look at a butterfly and the butterfly's like got all these beautiful colors, but the butterfly's doing its thing and it's real pretty. If you're an animal and like you see another animal and it's stuck there and it's captivated your attention and it's intentionally making itself look pretty, it's trying to get your attention. And why is it trying to get your attention? Because it wants to fucking eat you.
You realize that when you speak to many, and I spoke to many First Nations people in Canada, from the Mi'kmaq and the Anishinaabe, and they have very similar stories as well. They have star lodges. Some of their wampum belts have different constellations that they say that's our ancestry. It comes from these particular constellations. So like the minute you get into this rabbit hole,
I know,
and you talk to the ancient peoples and then you read the ancient texts, you go, oh my God, they're all telling you the same story. They just named them different things and slightly different. But my question was, did they in Australia, did they talk about the time before the moon? Is that?
Yes. Yeah.
They spoke about a time before the moon and then.
The time before the moon. Yeah. So that it's actually moon man here. It's not feminine. So
there could be the human element, or are we dealing with something bigger? So here's the question. Are we only dealing with some corrupted psychopathic humans who crave unlimited power, money, and influence, which could be, and of course, much of what I'm going to show you in the series could be answered by the assertion, by that assertion. But then you sit back and you go, given the anti-human ideology at the root of much of this cult's belief system, Is this purely a human agenda in the end? Or is there something non-human involved at the highest levels of all of this, as many ancient myths, legends, and scriptures from all over the world discuss?
You have to fully be yourself. You have to speak your truth. You have to stand in your power. Because one thing that I've really realized, you know, since protesting and like being pretty hardcore in the protesting scene, is that like if you want to create any sort of change, the only thing that you can do is just lead by example. That's literally all it comes down to. You have to live a happy, healthy life, and you have to show other people how it's done. You can't go and change the world. You can't change every single person. Just change yourself, and people see what you're doing and they're like, hey, you know, you look happy, you look healthy, like, what are you doing? And then that inspires them to be themselves. So yeah, you've really just got to be in your power, and that gives other people permission to be themselves and, you know, speak their truth and fully be in their power.
But, and I noticed that around this eye here, I was starting to get that patchy skin, you know, like you see with Henry Kissinger, you know, how all the entity attached people have that motley, horrible skin like Prince Philip, and, you know. And I thought, oh, that's a bit sus. Had people come in that were, you know, trans, wanting to be, you know, they were wanted to be transgender, dressed, cross-dressed or whatever. And he often saw an entity attached that was the opposite sex of that person. And if the entity was removed, then they'd lose all that desire to be of the opposite sex.
It's part Māori, part Pākehā or white. I'm very proud of both sides of where I come from. I don't stand on one side, I don't stand on the other. It's been the best chapter of my life. You know, as much as the world's burning around you, what is being presented and what is coming forward is the most beautiful thing that will ever intend to come forward. So I can see that coming through. I can see that grass growing. I can see those flowers starting to bloom. So, you know, that's what I keep focused on. And the negatives out here, I understand it. I know it. I'm aware of it. I know what's going on. But I'm focused on building that new. I'm here to give this land to the next generations that came. I am a sacrifice.
I want to be having these conversations with people because I could really see how vast it all went. But this is why the conference was an idea, because I was like, the magic is really happening in the conversations and the different layers and perspectives that people bring that from walks of life, I can't walk in this life. You know, maybe I've walked another life, but it's like bringing in all these different elements. And that is like, that's been the magic. And for me, it's really important that we, you know, support people that have taken the time to learn, you know, and honor the truth and share it. Yeah, till next time. See yous.